So you are bloated and exhausted by the end of the day. You feel that your belly, your tummy is rock solid, it is stiff, and it's not a pleasant sensation. You probably know everything there is to know about your physical symptom: constipation, inflammation, food intolerance, indigestion. But I'm here to talk about the metaphysics involved in what you are experiencing physically. What's going on with your energy? What is going on with the invisible realms? So stay with me, we have much to talk about. Hello ladies, welcome to this channel. My name is Mari. I am a natural healer, a herbologist, a dance teacher, and a woman's therapist. And for the past 20 years, I've been helping women to reconnect with their bodies, their true nature, and their essence. Subscribe to the channel, help me spread the message out to our sisters, like this video, share this video with a friend, and let's get to work. So we are not our physical bodies. And whatever we are experiencing in the physical body is a reflection of something going on in the invisible realms. We are a combination of thoughts and feelings and emotions. And there's also energy, vibration, and there's also spirituality. And so when you experience a physical symptom, that is a clear message of your physical body to express what's going on in the invisible realms. So the first thing you need to know is that women have energy receptors, like invisible energy cells in their pelvic region. And this is the natural process in which dimensions are opened and interconnected to another soul to come, another energy, a foreign energy to the woman's body comes in and blends with her own energy, and that becomes a beautiful baby. That's how women get pregnant. They have this powerful and amazing ability to connect to another reality, to connect to other beings, to connect to other energies. And that's how they become pregnant. That's in the project of our bodies. These cells are designed to do that. These days, we are living lives that are so accelerated and we are so disconnected from our bodies. And more than that, we are not being pregnant as much as we were in the past. These receptors are still active and they are lacking leadership. So these cells are very active. They are energy, invisible cells, but they are very active. They are like little jellyfish, or you can think of a flower. And they are specialist, expert cells in connecting to energies. Most of the time, women connect to energy, an unconscious process. We don't know that we do it, and we spend part of our days, or maybe the whole day, connecting to energies, embracing energies, because that's what women are designed to do. And we lack knowledge of our own body. We don't really connect to the body, and the body is trying to talk to us all day. This stiffness in the belly region is probably your body telling you that you are collecting energy. You are walking around embracing situations, people, vibrations in general, but specifically when it's a problem and we identify with the problem. So let's say you're having coffee with a friend and this friend is very miserable because many things are happening, bad things are happening to her, she feels blocked, and you are listening to that, and somehow without you noting, because your body is without command, your energy receptors embrace the situation, embrace the problem. By the end of the day, it's like you're pregnant with many vibrations, with many energies, with people's problems, with sometimes it's an image through the television or on your cell phone, and you get pregnant with that. If your body is waiting for your command, your body is waiting for leadership. So command your body in the morning not to embrace people's energy, not to embrace people's problems. Talk to your receptors. Command them to connect exclusively with good things, good vibrations, light, vitality, love, inspiration, creativity. You know, people with good vibes, that's a good thing to connect, but not with problems. So the second thing we need to talk about is that sometimes we get pregnant and overdue. And I do not mean really a physical baby. Our thoughts, our dreams, our projects, our plans, they are our children. It's possible that you spent your whole life pregnant with them and they're overdue and you don't give birth to that. That creates in your physical body bloating. It is really like you are pregnant. You may experience pregnancy physically because your dreams are there and they are overdue. So if a woman is pregnant and she's over 42 weeks in the pregnancy, there's already an alert because that baby needs to come. There's a certain window for that to come. It's the same with projects and dreams and desires and something that you need to experience to fulfill yourself. So give birth to your dreams. It doesn't matter if it's writing a poem, if it's painting something, if it's sewing something, if it's building a garden, if it's traveling to a tropical island that you have always wanted to see and experience, go and do that. There's energy that needs to be manifested and you are retaining it. And it really happens because we constantly as women prioritize other beings other than ourselves. Or maybe you are pregnant of your true version. The true self is there. It's in your belly and it needs to come to the light. It needs to manifest itself in the material world. It needs to exist because we put on several masks and characters. There's a whole wardrobe. She's the good woman. She's the warrior. Which one of those are really you? And most of the time, it's none of them. It's something very unique. It's something very authentic, but it's inside of you. So give birth to your dreams, give birth to your plans, give birth to your projects, give birth to yourself. Don't allow them to be overdue. Don't wait until you're 80 to start thinking about yourself. Start thinking about yourself and act on it right now. And the third thing that can be happening to you in terms of energy is like an emotional turmoil. So emotions are a bit different than feelings because emotions, they are very body connected. Emotions are felt strongly and intensely in the body. So in ancient traditions, the way that you beat a monster, the way that you defeat a demon is by naming the demon, because this evil entity only has power over you when you don't know that it is acting on you. So name your demons. When we get blocked in our pelvic region, first, second, and third chakras, it usually has to do with a system of thought contraction. There comes an image, you get worried, the body responds, but it is very automatic and it's very unconscious. So perhaps you are experiencing fear on a day-to-day basis. Perhaps you are worried about your survival, having enough money. Perhaps you are experiencing, and this is a very common symptom these days, anxiety, thought worry, and your muscles contract and you contract and the organs contract. And there's this whole blockage in your energy, in your pelvic region. Scan your mind, scan your day-to-day thoughts, and name the demon. That will release that energy because your body is trying to tell you, hey, we're overwhelmed here with fear, but because you don't know it, then this dynamic goes on and on and on and on. And sometimes it really becomes a physical and serious thing, like an ulcer or a tumor. So repeated thoughts in a negative frequency, they are a lot for the body. They overwhelm the body. So name your demon. Is it fear? Is it anger? Is it anxiety? Is it impatience? Is it frustration? All of those emotions, they are really connected to this region, and they might be causing the blockage in your energy. The more you dig into your shadow corners, and the more that you bring this material up, the more that you bring this stuff up, the easier it gets to the body. So our bodies are constantly talking to us. Learn to connect to them. So to sum it all up, command your receptors, your energy receptors, to not collect other people's energy or energy from situations or images or television or bad news. Only connect to good things. Banish all kinds of negative stimulus from your life. Give birth to your dreams. Give birth to your true self. Allow yourself to be who you are. Most of us are with our true selves overdue inside our uterus. So give this creature the opportunity to come to light and share your light with the world. And name your demons. Do not allow this thought contraction dynamic to go on for the rest of your life. It would be really good if you could take 5 minutes a day to talk to your body. Scan your body, talk to it. If you're experiencing any kind of symptoms from a headache or a back pain, let's invert this cycle that we experience a symptom and go running to the doctor so the doctor will tell us what's going on. Talk to your body. Your body is constantly talking to you. Just give your body 5 minutes a day to understand the message. Allow images to come. Scan your body, scan your mind. Step away from the automatism. Be aware. This is the channel where I bring ancient wisdom into your day-to-day life so you can read and reconnect with your body, your natural cycles, and save a lot of money in healthcare just by talking to yourself and getting to know yourself a bit more. I hope this was helpful for you. Please remember to like this video, share this video, subscribe to the channel to support the work. Thanks for watching. Take good care of yourselves. Take good care of your bodies. May the goddess bless us all. And I'll see you in my next video.